A hearty good morning to you, my brothers and sisters in St. Lucia, especially our brothers and sisters in our four congregations, Castries, Ciceron, Rosalie, and Forestier. We also greet our brothers and sisters in the diaspora and friends of Methodism. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, as we hope that this service will be a blessing to all of you. The Methodist Church is pleased once again to bring you our Sunday service, today being memorial service via this medium, and we encourage you to invite your friends to join us in this act of worship. Our service begins with the singing of the hymn number 13 in the VIP, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise. To the call to worship, the congregation is invited to make the appropriate response. Let us remember the two world wars and other conflicts which have devastated the lives of so many in the last 100 years. We think especially of those known to us. Let us remember those who are working and fighting for peace and justice. Let us remember those engaged in the struggle for justice. Together, God of peace, lover of justice, take our thanksgiving and turn it into active compassion for the victims of aggression and violence, whether they are labeled aliens or allies, enemies or friends. May they experience the grace of forgiving and the healing power of love. Take our rage and turn it into potent anger in all forms of injustice, all attempts to dominate others through violence, all identification of right with force. May our anger burn until we see peace built of the foundation of justice and freedom from oppression. Our prayer of adoration. O Holy Lord, you are worthy of all our praises. You reign in majesty above us and our Lord forever. Your name is glorious and wonderful. Everyone on earth and heaven sing about your wondrous works. You are the King of all, and we worship you, our Lord. We bless you, Lord, for allowing us to be graced by your presence today. Hallowed be your name. Accept our love and adoration in Jesus' name. We are here to pray, Almighty God, that you will always light our way with your presence. We resist evil and pray that your light will always shine on us. May all people see your glory through us and come to worship you as the living God. My brothers and sisters, let us confess to God the sins and the shortcomings of the world, its pride, its selfishness, its greed, its evil, divisions, and hatred. Let us confess our share in what is wrong and our failure to seek and establish that peace which God wills for his children. Together we say, most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been, help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. The assurance of pardon. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We continue to praise God in song as we turn to our voice in praise, number 248, Ye Servants of God. thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. But above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. As we prepare ourselves for the ministry of the word, we prayerfully recite the collect appointed for today. Eternal God, in whose perfect realm no sword is drawn but the sword of justice, and no strength known but the strength of love, guide and inspire all who seek your kingdom, that peoples and nations may find their security in the love which casts our fears through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Our scripture reading, Psalm 46, verses 1 to 11. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, and though mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in uproar, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Our hymn of preparation in the Methodist hymn book this time, Methodist hymn book 252, God is with us, 252 in the Methodist hymn book.
Yeah.
invite our Reverend Ampadu to bring us the message.
My brothers and sisters, I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus the Christ. Amen. Let me express gratitude to all of you for coming out this morning. We appreciate your coming. We pray to God that the presence of God will continue to be with all of us. Let us bow our heads as we go to God in prayer. Let us thank God in our hearts for his goodness and mercies upon our lives. By his grace and his mercies, we are on the land of the living. So just thank God for your life, your family, your friends, your loved ones. And so, Lord, this blessed morning, as we bow our heads, we give you thanks, we give you praise. We lift your name higher above any other name. Who is like unto you, O God? You are the King of the kings. You are the Lord of the lords. So today, Lord, we ascribe unto you all your majesty. We want to thank you for our lives. We want to thank you, God, for the many blessings that you have showered upon us. Today we are so blessed to be in your presence. Lord, we commit ourselves to you, especially as your word is coming to us. We pray that, Lord, you talk to us. Let the power in your word reach out to us, O God, and to liberate us from all the trials and the challenges that confront each one of us, O God. Even as your word is coming, O God, those our brothers and sisters who are sick, who are afflicted, who are in pain, those who are troubled in heart, we ask, O God, that you reach out to them and give them a new hope, renew their strength. The Bible says they that wait upon you, they shall renew their strength. So Lord, renew our strength. That Lord, we will continue to look up to you. As I stand before your people, O God, to deliver your message to them, hide me behind the cross of Jesus Christ. And Lord, speak through me to your people, O God. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be pleasing unto you, O God. You are our Redeemer, O God. May your name be blessed and glorified through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Today, our text for meditation is from Psalm 46, 1 to 3. Psalm 46, verses 1 to 3. God is our refuge and strength, very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult, we will not be afraid, because God is with us. So our theme for this morning is, no matter what life brings, we are safe in the care of God. No matter what life brings, we are safe in the care of God. My brothers and sisters, as you heard from Brother Krem during the introductory part, today we observe as Memorial Sunday. We celebrate and remember our forefathers and mothers of our nation. our courageous armed men and women who fought during the world wars. We remember also our loved ones who have left us to eternity. We remember and celebrate their sacrifice, their commitment, and their dedication. My brothers and sisters, some of these, our forefathers and mothers, they risked their fortunes, they risked their families, their reputations, and their honor in order for us to be survived. Some also risked their very lives, and many of them paid for our freedom with their own blood and the blood of their children. As we celebrate this Remembrance Sunday, we need to be mindful that thousands of our forefathers and mothers, they laid down their lives so that this world and our country can celebrate this day. We should never forget their sacrifices, their torture, their beating and wounds. Some were imprisoned, some were chained, some were shot to death to purchase our freedom today. We need to celebrate them. In fact, the hymn writer says, "Now praise we great and famous men, the fathers named in story, and praise the Lord who now as then reveals in man his glory." And stanza 2 says, "Praise we the wise and brave and strong, who graced their generation, who helped the right and fought the wrong, and made our folk a nation." And stanza 4 reads, "Praise we the peaceful men, and I'm adding women of skill, who builded homes of beauty, and rich in art, made richer still the brotherhood and sisterhood of duty." So my brothers and sisters, this celebration should also remind us about the sacrifices of Jesus Christ. The sacrifice that Jesus made over 2,000 years ago for the entire world. Jesus was beaten. He was tortured, spitted onto, crucified in order to set us free from sin and shame. It is in this light that we approach our theme for today. No matter what life brings, we are safe in the care of God. Today, my brothers and sisters, the question I would like to pose to all of us: when life becomes uncertain, what do we do? When world events threaten to change our lives, like this COVID-19 pandemic, how do we handle it? Do we have a shelter for our life storms? Is the Lord our refuge? Does he give us strength to stand in times of crisis? Or do we try and make it on our own? When our world is turned upside down, like we are experiencing today, how do we respond? Do we respond with fear or with faith? Let us remember that our forebears, they lived by faith. God was their refuge. God was their strength and their help. And therefore, we can learn from them. So, in our text, in the context of this psalm, the psalmist invites us to focus our attention on God when life threatens us. When the psalmist says, "God is our refuge, our strength, a very present help in times of trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed And though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, we will not be afraid. So if you look at this Psalm 46 is the answer to our concerns for today. It is our answer to our worries and our needs. It focuses on the psalmist as he encourages believers in times of troubles. Some biblical scholars believe that David was the writer of this psalm. In the text, the psalmist understood what it meant to be devastated by trouble on every hand. For the psalmist, believers should trust and hope in God when times are difficult, like we find ourselves in the second wave of coronavirus. In such times, the psalmist encourages us to remember what God has done in the past and look forward with expectation for the great things he is going to do in the future. The psalmist encourages us to sing praise to God despite the difficulties surround us, because he is our eternal strength. He is in control in the midst of the tragedies that confront us. He is with us, and he is our source of security, our source of hope. My brothers and sisters, we notice in this psalm, the psalmist celebrates God's presence in the temple on Mount Zion, a presence that promised security, blessings to God's people. This psalm was written during the time of catastrophe and enemies attacking. The psalmist says, God is our refuge in times of trouble. Even when the earth falls out from under our feet, even when chaos surrounds us, even when coronavirus threatens our lives, even when the doctor says it is impossible for you to live, the Lord is our refuge. Even when your bank account is empty, when your marriage hit the rock, when your job application is rejected, God is your refuge. He is your protector and your safe shelter, and we can trust and depend on this God. So this morning, as we remember our forefathers and mothers who have passed on to the glory, the psalmist is reminding us, especially this crisis time that we find ourselves, we are to rely on God's strength, because God is our refuge. He is our source of security. He is our strength. My brothers and sisters, there are three ways the psalmist invites us to depend on the Lord in times of crisis. The psalmist invites us, first, we are to depend on God as our refuge. The psalmist wants us to depend on God as our refuge. We are to take refuge in God. It is only God that we can be secured. So verse 1 of our text, he says, God is our refuge and strength, very present help in trouble. My brothers and sisters, the psalmist says God is our refuge. And the word refuge suggests or means a shelter. It means hope. It means trust. It speaks of a place of safety. The point is, trouble comes into all our lives each day, but we can seek refuge in the Lord, because God is able to protect us in times of trouble. So Proverbs chapter 18, verse number 10, it says, the name of the Lord It's a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. My brothers and sisters, this morning, let God be your refuge, your hiding place. So in the text, the psalmist always found refuge in the Lord. When his enemies sought his life. So if you look at David, the supposed writer of this psalm, Saul pursued David for many years, yet God always protected him. David knew that the Lord was watching over him. We learn to depend on God as our refuge when we know God enough to depend on him. So God can be your refuge only when you know him enough so that he can be your refuge. So the psalmist suggests two ways. We need to know that God is enough for us. We are to know him as the Lord of hosts. So verse 7 of the text says, the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Again, the psalmist invites us to know God as the God of Jacob. So verse 11 reads, the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. My brothers and sisters, those who make the Lord their refuge do not put their trust in the strength of their own in rough times like we are experiencing today. But they live daily with confidence that no matter what tragedy may befall them, they are secured in the Lord. Those people are unshaken. They are unmovable. And in fact, Psalm 125 verses 1 and 2 put it this way. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved, but abides forever. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people from this time on and forevermore. So the first lesson that we need to learn today is that we need to learn to depend on God for our refuge. The second thing the text brings to light is that we are to depend on God for our strength. You see, the arms of strength will fail. We need to depend on the strength of God in each day. And David is inviting us because he depended on God for strength. And we also can depend on him for our daily strength. So if you look at the word strength, it means power. It means mighty, boldness, to be mighty. So when trials and troubles come, sometimes our strength is drained from us. Yet these times, God is able to strengthen us and help us to stand when we depend on his strength. We only need to ask him for strength. It doesn't matter how strong or weak we are. We all need God's strength because our own strength will fail us. Only he can sustain us in trials of life. In fact, Isaiah chapter 40, verse 28 to 31, it reads, have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak, and to those who have not might, he increases their strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. My brothers and sisters, the renewing of our strength require that we wait upon the Lord. Even in the midst of great trials, we put our hope in Jesus and nothing else. So the hymn writer says, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other grounds is sinking sand. My brothers and sisters, we must rely on God's strength. To rely on God's strength, it means that we should look to God as a child, as our children look up to us. It means to place our worries on Him. God knows how to give you the power to overcome. He knows how to take off our weaknesses. He knows how to take our failures, our doubts, our fears, and He will turn them into miracles of deliverance. So in the text, the psalmist was greatly distressed, but strengthened himself in the Lord God. When trials come, the question is, do we strengthen ourselves in the Lord or in our own strength? Do we try and make it on our own? God is always ready to strengthen us. So in times of trouble, our strength is restored by allowing God to move into our lives. Our strength is not of this world, but our strength is found in Jesus Christ alone. In having a vibrant relationship with Jesus Christ, dynamic relationship with Jesus Christ, it restores our strength. The fact is, our flesh and heart may fail, but God gives us strength to move on. My brothers and sisters, when we are weak, when we are helpless, let us look to God. He is the source of our strength. And the third thing that the psalmist is inviting us to do, to depend on God, is that we need to depend on the help of God. God gives His people help. My brothers and sisters, let me tell you, in this life, nobody can help apart from God. And sometimes God brings people in our lives to bring help. But we should not depend on people. We need to depend on the help of God. So if you look at the word help, it means to assist someone, to support, a helping hand. So God provides refuge and strength to His people, but He also helps us in times of trouble. He does that from a distance. He is right there with us to help us in our trials. So in Hebrews chapter 13, verses 5 and 6, He says, for He Himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man or woman do to me? So let's see God as our helper in times of trial. God doesn't expect us to make it on our own. He is ever ready. So the psalmist says, He is what? Ever present help. He's always willing to help. But sometimes we think we can make it on our own. He knows that we cannot. It is only pride and fear that keep us from seeking God's help. We think we are so strong. We think we can do it without Him. And that is why we fail and fail and fail. It is time for us to trust God. To test God by allowing Him to help us. Will you determine to seek God's help each day in your life? Will you allow God to take control of the trials in your life? God is always waiting to answer our prayers. In 1 Psalm 34, verse 17, 19 says, the righteous cry out, and the Lord hears and delivers them out of their troubles. The Lord is near to those who have a broken heart and saves such as have a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. So we need to depend on God for our help. Finally, my brothers and sisters, there is a reason for confidence in God. The psalmist is inviting us to place our confidence in God. And there is a reason for us to do that. We need to be confident in God because of the awareness of the nearness of God. He is ever present. God is always around us, and therefore we should have that confidence. So the text says, God is in the midst of her people. It means that though the earth be moved, God is not moved. The earth will break into pieces, but God never breaks. Though the mountains be shaken, God is never shaken. So we should have that confidence in God, that even if the earth breaks, he never breaks. My brothers and sisters, though all may fall, God stands. So we can have confidence in this God. Today, let us have this assurance that when everyone else seems to be against us, the creator and the sustainer of the universe is indeed in our corner. He is our portion. We have his power with us on every side of our way. He won't leave us. When the fighting gets off, he will stand in front of us to protect us. He never leaves us or forsakes us in times of trouble. It doesn't matter what odds against you. The Lord is on your side. It doesn't matter how dark and hopeless the situation looks. He is still your portion. It doesn't matter what you are up against. The Lord is on your side. It doesn't matter if the pain is uncontrollable. The Lord is on your side. It doesn't matter if the enemy comes in like a flood. The Lord is on our side. So today, my brothers and sisters, the psalmist is inviting us. We know we are in the difficult times. We need to depend on God for our safety, our refuge. We need to depend on God for our daily strength. He renews our strength when we depend on him. And again, we need to depend on him for help. No other help apart from the help from above. So today, be reminded as we remember our forefathers and mothers, their bravery. Let us remember that God is with us. No matter what happens, he is in charge. Let us bow our heads as we go to God in prayer. Today, the question is, just ponder over this message that has come to you. Who is the source of your strength? Is it your doctor or the medication that you have in your closet or in your kitchen cabinet or at the top of your bed? The medication is your source of strength. Who is your helper? Is it your husband, your boyfriend, girlfriend? The psalmist is inviting us that we should depend on God for help. And so, Lord, today as we remember our brave mothers and fathers who have gone before us, we thank you for your message that you have given to us, that no matter what comes, we are safe in your presence. So we pray, O God, from today onwards, help us, O God, to agree with the psalmist that you becomes our source of refuge, hiding place in this troublous life. You become our source of strength when we are weak. Help us, O God, to find our strength in you, that you will be our source of help. No matter what comes on our way, you will see us through. So Lord, we pray and praise ourselves under your care in these troubled times, where it seems the wall of coronavirus, O God, becomes so heavy on us. We pray that, Lord, hide us under your pavilion, O God. Strengthen our faith in you so that we will not be overwhelmed by the spread of this second wave of coronavirus. We know that you are in charge. So, Lord, be with your people. Continue to strengthen us. Those, O God, who have been infected by the virus, O God, we plead the blood of Jesus to neutralize, O God, this virus in them and heal them, O God. We pray and come against the spread in our communities, O God. We pray for your hands to be strong upon our nation, our lives, so that we will have your peace. May your name be glorified through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen and amen. Thank you.
We thank Rev'd Ampadu for his words of inspiration. And in response, we turn to the Methodist hymn book, 878, as we sing, O God, our help in ages past. As we remember those who have gone before us, our forefathers who fought in the two world wars. now have our intercessory prayers and the response from the congregation will be, give peace in our hearts, O Lord. Give peace in our hearts, O Lord. Living Lord, in a dark hour you spoke of the gift of peace. We seek that gift for ourselves. Grant us, we pray, the inner serenity which you alone can give, that we may become messengers of peace to strife-torn world. Give peace in our time, O Lord. Give peace in our hearts, O Lord. We pray for all who suffer, for their fidelity to the calling to be your witnesses. All who suffer for trying to live by truth they have received, and all who are slandered, ill-treated, falsely imprisoned or tortured, crucified and risen, Lord, may they, sharing your anguish, know that they will also share your victory. Give peace in our time, O Lord. Give peace in our hearts, O Lord. We pray for all who suffer as a result of the wickedness and folly of others. We especially pray for those who suffer from the breakdown of law and order, from the absence of just and humane laws, and are thus denied the freedom to realize their birthrights as your children on this earth. Give peace in our time, O Lord. Give peace in our hearts. We pray for those who are fighting injury, disfigurement, death, their constant companions, nerves and bodies strained beyond endurance, the streams of compassion drying up within them, the only goal, the destruction of the enemy. Whatever the color of their skin, we pray for them. Whatever the sound of their tongue, we pray for them. Whatever the insignia they wear, we pray for them. Give peace in our time, O Lord. Give peace in our. We pray for all those who have been broken in battle, for those who wept, and for those who can no longer weep, for those who feel the anguish, and for those who have lost the capacity to feel, for all prisoners and for all jailers, for those who exist in war-torn lands, and for those who no longer have a homeland. Give peace in our time, O Lord. We pray for those who stir up strife, for all who make a profit out of the misery of others, for all who are led into vice as they seek a momentary forgetfulness, and for all who believe that the war is inevitable, we bring to you particular needs and remember those who have died. Lord, we pray that you may hold us fast amidst all the evils of this world, that at the last we may enter into the peace and joy of your kingdom. Give peace in our time, O Lord. Give peace. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give us peace, saying, may God give us peace. God give peace. For the servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God, may God give peace. God give peace. Together we say the prayer that our Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we bring our service to a close. We hope that our service has been an inspiration to you as we sing 357 in the voice and praise. Pleasant are the counts, are thy courts above. Pleasant are thy courts above. 357. Thank you.
My brothers and sisters, we want to thank all of you for coming out this morning. We appreciate your coming, and we thank God for your life. Let me stand on your behalf to wish our dear brother, Brother Clement Prosper, a hearty, happy birthday to you. May God continue to bless you for your service to God, and we pray that you celebrate more years with the strength that goes with it. God bless you. And let me also seize the opportunity to thank our technicians, Abel, Uncle Tim, Jamal, thank you. We appreciate your commitment. God bless you. Delora, yes, camera technician, God bless you. And of course, Uncle Prosper, God bless us all. Let us bow our heads. And so, Lord, we are so thankful to you for today. As we are living here to go to our various places, we thank you for reminding us that we should seek your you as a refuge, that we depend on you as our hiding place to renew our strength and also to be our helper. So as we go back into the world, no matter what tomorrow will bring to us, we will always see you as our refuge. We will seek you, O God, to be our source of strength and our help. Bless our lives. Bless our homes. Bless our children. Bless our co-workers. Whatever, O God, that is around us, we invoke your blessings upon. Bless our leaders and bless our nation. We pray through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Now let us receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his light of countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Have a wonderful week, and God bless us all. Let us also remember that the COVID fight, it is not over. So please adhere to the protocols so that we save and protect ourselves and others. Thank you very much. God bless us all.
Praise God for is from praise him, all creatures there beyond. Praise him above ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
God bless us.